Greetings, fellow Oathlings. Welcome back to the Elder Scrolls 2 Daggerfall's Mage. I did not see you there. Where the vent did you come? Walk up behind me there. Yeah, move away. Good job. Yeah, right. Don't you consider stopping. Anyway, we are right in front of the Order of Arkay in the Elysian Hills. And yeah, we're looking to get promoted again, essentially. I mean, I'm pretty certain that more than half my adventures in this playthrough will be the side quests, and that's honestly just the way to play Daggerfall. I mean, I do it a little more excessively. I tend to go to the very end of the journey for even the side factions, but yeah, that's where Daggerfall lies, essentially. It's not the main quest dungeons, it's all these side dungeons. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get some quests from them. You're inside as well, of course you are. Alright! Dunin Kinging. Wait, pre-quest slot. I keep forgetting to do that. Alright. Let's talk to him. Let us get a quest. It falls upon us to investigate the claims of Rodorian Wickfield that he has seen the face and heard the words of Arkay. Perhaps he has time to assist in this inquiry. This seems a little familiar. I think it's the Heretic questline, wherein apparently this guy's a heretic, and we essentially have to either head to a dungeon to find a priestess's missing finger, or talk to one of his associates to ascertain whether he has actually seen and heard the face and voice of this god, in our case Arkay. But I thought it was a Temple of Dibella exclusive questline. I guess it's probably not then, if you're getting it in Arkay as well. Good, we've already sent one of the temple, Bedurian Ashim, to the desacralized the Shrine of Demax. I mean, the name sort of threw me off, to the desacralized Shrine of Demax, just see that. Right. Where Rodorian Wickfield asserts that he first witnessed the miracle. If Bedurian Ashim needs assistance, I will send for you. In the meanwhile, I want you to find some more secular information on Rodorian Wickfield by asking around in his hometown, Crosswick. A loyal cleric of ours, Christeria Girton, will meet you in the Toad and the Fawn. I want to see evidence of the true nature of Rodorian Wickfield in no more than 67 days. I would leave immediately. May Great Arkay bless your enterprise, initiate. And yeah, it's pretty much the same quest. It's honestly a very long quest. I mean, we can actually go ahead and conduct some other quests while we're doing this. So we have two options here. We can either head straight to the dungeon, wherein we'll either find the priestess or we'll find her finger. And or we can just go to Crosswick and conduct the examination as is instructed to us. Now, the thing is, after we talk to the contact at Crosswick, they are going to tell us to talk to some local person, their lover, this, Rodorian's lover, essentially. And if we have a good enough repute with their faction, which is typically not the Order of Arkay, some other faction altogether, they'll let us know what we want to do. They'll tell us the truth or spill the beans about Roderick. However, if our score with the faction isn't high enough, we need to wait for a letter. The letter could be one of two things. It could either be... Let's head to Crosswick for now. Yeah. So, the letter could either be the Order of Arkay essentially asking us to head over to the dungeon where the priest or priestess, in our case it would be priest because you're playing as a male. Daggerfall makes sure that your companions in such cases are the same sex as you. So yeah, we'll either have to head to that priest or essentially find the priest's finger in the dungeon. Or we'll essentially get evidence of the fact that Rodorian is essentially making all of this up. Now, which tavern did I have to go to again? Christeria Girton, of course. Looks like we're gonna have to ask some people here. about Crystaria Gaten? One of you, perhaps? People. Crystaria Gaten. I don't have a clue. Of course, you don't. Hello, she says. Crystaria Gaten. I don't know nothing about Crystaria Gaten, and I ain't seen anymore. Charisma. And I'll make sure to make my teeth especially charismatic. Me? Help you? Ha ha ha! Huh. Bitch. Okay, people, Crystaria Gaten. Sorry, friend, I can't help you though. Yep, that's what happens when your charisma is too low. But eventually somebody will succumb. Ask someone else, strange blood, I'm running late myself. Gotcha. What is it? Crystaria Gaten, listen, I don't give directions to people to talk to me like that. Okay, how about Blunt? Listen, I ain't got time for this. Why don't you just kiss off, strange blood? Kiss off, huh? I'm supposing that's a more polite form of, well, F off. Why the hell would I want to give you directions, strange blood? Valid point, I suppose. Valid point. Well, try not too far to the south if you don't mind walking. Okay. But, of course I'll help you. Just go away south of here. But what exactly am I looking for? Is the question. Let's go south and try asking again. Maybe it'll turn up some results. Yeah, and this quest has like a lot of potential endings. You can actually go ahead and Resolution of Zen. I hope that is not the faction that I have to get, you know, have to be affiliated with or need my reputation to be higher in. Let us go ahead and ask this person, although he probably wouldn't know anything. It's really easy. We want to go west of here. West, huh? Back that way. So I guess it's not the Resolution of Zen, at least. So yeah, that's essentially what it is. I should meditate on what I've learned about streets-wise. I could ask this horse, but I'm pretty certain that this horse would not know any better. Oh god, what a pleasant surprise. Yes, could you tell me about Crystaria Gaten? Simple, you'll find it right there. Points to the toad and fawn on your map. Ah, if you could not have done that before. Thank you, right here. So yeah, you can actually confront that guy with the letter, but but if you do that, he'll just disappear with it, and it'll be mission failed. You can also alternately take the letter to his lover, and then she'll spin the beans as well. Right here. Ah, hello, strange blood. Welcome to Crossvik. The whole town is in a buzz about that young Roderin Wickfield, but he isn't even here. He's in the Laughing Fawn pub at a tavern called The Toad in the Dungeon, working on a new tract about what this mysterious spirit of the Shrine of Demax had to say about the moral disintegration of the Order of Arkay. He's essentially besmirching our temple at this point. Here's a copy of the original tractate, so you would know what this Rotorian Wickfield's all about. Dangerous character from what I've seen so far. I'm communicating with Barbona Yonton, a young lady in green in Greenham Manor, with whom Rotorian Wickfield has some kind of relationship. Okay. It wouldn't be a bad idea for you to go to Greenham Manor and see if you can't persuade her to talk to us. Hope all this is helpful information. Strange blood. Excuse me, sort of choked there. So now we're headed to Greenham Manor. And alright. Hold up. No. That's where Roderick is. Toad and Dungeon, the Laughing Fawn Pub. No, that is not where I want to go. I want to go to Greenham Manor, and said, alright, I guess we're traveling the old way, because the way that it is set up that way, it's essentially going to cause a failure. We can't exactly go and confront him about anything. That is like one of the... You actually get a chance, I mean... You can confront him once and he disappears with, you know, whatever evidence you have, and then you get another chance to redeem yourself. And if you still go out and contact him again, he'll just disappear again. So, fool me once, shame on me. Fool me twice? No, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. Yeah. Anyway. Alright, so who were we looking for again? Barbona Yeomton. Right. Excuse me there. Hello. Barbona Yeomton. Yes, strange, but I don't think I'm gonna tell you where to find Barbona Yeomton. Of course you don't. What about you? You need something? Yep. So, look at their first opening statement. That'll tell you whether to use polite, normal, or blunt. Yeah. Yes, strange, but I don't think I want to tell you where to find Barbona Yeomton. Right. What is it? Everybody's blunt here. Gotta be somewhere around here. Listen up, where's Barbona Yeomton? Gotta be somewhere around here. Have I talked to you yet? I don't think so. Hello? Well, that should be a normal response. Yes. I don't have the first clue, I'm afraid. Now if you'll excuse me. What about you? Could you perhaps help me? How can I help you, stranger? Sounds pretty normal. Ask someone else. Can't you see I'm busy? Busy doing what? Just strolling about? Let us ask her first, then we can ask her. Or the other people. Good day. Good day to you too. Why on Tamriel would I want you to know, strange blood? Huh. What can I do for you, stranger? People, Barbona Yeomton. Don't know, don't care, and don't want to talk to you anymore. Goodbye. Charisma, charisma. It's all a game of charisma, isn't it? What is it? By the dragon, as if I know. Ask someone else. Oh wait, yeah, that's right, Blunt. Go on and find a friend or someone who knows something. I ain't either. Yes? Normal. People, Barbona Yeomton. Gotta be somewhere around here. You need something? Yep. Oh, Blunt. Barbona Yeomton. By the wolf, as if I know. Ask someone else. So what is it about the wolf and the dragon that they are so fond of? You need something? Yep. What's your name again? Oh, Barbisa Yeomham. I was like, wait, aren't you the woman that I'm looking for? But she's supposed to be all green. There's no reason to talk down to me like that. I can't help you anyway. Nah, I wasn't talking down to you. I was just matching your tone. How can I help you, stranger? Excuse me, though. Another fail? Ask someone who gives a damn. What do you want? Why don't you try asking me like a normal human being would? Okay. Begging your pardon, but that's such a stupid question. I think I should have to answer. Yes. Barbona Yeomton. Don't know, don't care, don't want to talk to you anymore. Goodbye. What is it? Barbona Yeomton. You'll find it southeast of here. Thank you. The only person that has actually helped. So, given the fact that this is like a tiny little place, I'm guessing it's gonna be either of these places. Yep, Wickfield Residence, right here. Oh, yeah, I was already on foot. So, the way you know that the door is facing the marsh, why? So, the way you know that a contact might be in residence is when the residence actually... The name of the residence has a name in it, essentially. It's a not just residence, it's a named residence, like the Wickfield residence. Someone calls out, come in. Oh, I like the sound of the hearth there. She should most likely be here. come on. After much practice, you feel ready to advance further in climbing. So that's what happens when your strength stat is too low. Alright, let's talk to her then. Whatever they say, I never knew that Rodor in Wickfield. Tell Christira Gerton she has the wrong young lady in green. Sorry about that. Yeah, so my repute with her faction is probably not high enough, being the reason why she's not giving me any information. So from this point on, it's a waiting game. So all we need to do, all we can do, is essentially just wait here. And that's pretty much it. We just wait around for information. So with that in mind, let's just travel back over to Elysian Hills. Because I've sent people to pick up from there. I mean, this quest actually gives you like a long time to solve it. I'm surprised that a zombie hasn't been sent after me yet. Persons of the Knight of the Wheel are to be detained upon sight. What's the time right now? 7 o'clock in the morning? Okay, I guess we'll just... Not that. Yeah. Yeah. We're headed to the center. The town center. Ooh, the lightning. How are the birds flying in the rain though? That seems to be an oversight. Holy shit. Was that like a bear from the lightning? Nice. Nice indeed. Move out of the way! Out of the way, commoners. Holy shit, that is intense lightning there. But yeah, I'm probably gonna have to wait here for like 2 hours. Or can I like loiter here for like 1.5 hours? Is that possible? Nope. It has to be an integer, can't be like binary. So let me just go ahead and pick up my adamantium stuff. That looks pretty nice actually. But this is apparently the extent to which I can order things. I cannot order any orcish or datic stuff. And maybe that's because I made my character incapable of equipping them. So I think I've installed such a mod where I don't even get things that I cannot equip. It gets in the way of me completing my staff collection, honestly. Okay. Let's pull out the wagon and let's move the stuff. Oh right, I need to unequip it first. That is new. I'll go with this one and I'll remove this to the wagon into my collection. And one of the other things that I want to do is bring out, where did it go? The ebony dagger. Right here. Yeah, so I want to more or less just take it back into my inventory and keep it there. I've got lots of clothes to change into. I'm just not changing into them right now. A lot of alchemical ingredients as well. Just need access to the potion maker first. Okay, so with that I'm done. The Heretic. I do remember them giving me like 67 days to complete it, so it's probably gonna... Any sort of information is probably going to arrive pretty late. So I suppose all we can do at this point is just spend the time traveling. This is one of those long-term quests you can't exactly expect to complete it as soon as you get it. Alright, so with that in mind, let us then travel to... Well, I don't know where. Anywhere? Blessed Shrine of Julianus. Tulum, okay. Yomsley Plantation. What is this? Hearthcroft Orchard. The Tombs of Copperhouse. Shrine of Dugrod. Singing Seer of Julianus. How long is it, would it take for us to... Vicard Farmstead? Travel time to 60s? That's a little too close, actually. I want to travel somewhere a little further, maybe something that would take me like 20 days, essentially. So this is like one region of Daggerfall that you do not want to go into. I think it was over here or somewhere over here, but the game glitches out when you try to go in there. Like fast travel to any city over there. Bahrain? Any place in Bahrain? Just 16 days. Anticlare, maybe? Lion and Dagger Lodge, 18 days of travel time. I mean, while we're at it, we might as well just complete a quest for the Mage's Guild, I suppose. Buckingham Tombs. Corpuscin Graveyard, Kingdom Graveyard, Crypts of Humesmith, Corpus the Crypts. Where was the crypt that I had, like, raided recently, I wonder? Coagre, maybe? I mean, it's been a while since I went here. Nah. That's here. Gearing Palace, 24 days. Sounds good. Sounds good to me. Yeah, let's go. A young lad hands you a letter and scurries off. So this is essentially the letter that we had been waiting for. And yeah, I should... Like teleporting back to where we want to go now should help us out. But first, let us read this letter, whether we have to visit the dungeon or something else. We'll follow shortly hereafter. Replace. Huh. Interesting. The Toad and Fawn Crossvic. The Toad and Fawn Crossvic. Dear Strangeblood, there's been a horrible accident here at the Toad and Fawn involving Tristeria Gaten. Please come when you can. Yours sincerely. Vivin... Vanivira Wickfield. That's the first time I've seen that letter. I scarcely remember my voyage to the place called the Shrine of Timanx. I expect I was still partly dreaming. Deep within the stinking recesses of the profane temple, I was met with a great fire, and from the flames I heard the same voice speak. Welcome. Who art thou? I address the flame. I am what the Order of Arkay doth proclaim to worship, but with every act and thought defile my divinity. To thee I call, so that anew the Order of Arkay might be created, one led by truth and true insight and understanding of my being. The heathen need insight, and you shall be it. The god told me more that day, but while the Order of Arkay continues their policy of quashing anyone who dare to challenge their corrupted, contemptible theology, I must keep my track short. More will follow shortly hereafter. Yeah, that's essentially the letter that that guy had written. Princess of Vedas, letter of credit, and that is the potion recipe. So this is like a like an invitation to the Toad and the Fawn. This is most likely the route where we get the evidence and don't exactly have to go dungeon crawling. Now, I don't exactly need to go inside of this residence. The only reason why I'm doing that is so that I can charge up enough to cast teleport once again and head back to the anchor that I had set. We still do have like 30 odd days to finish this. So I'm not in any kind of a hurry either. Interesting rooms. Interesting rooms. As much as I would like to talk to you, I must now teleport back. Well, apparently I can't do that yet. I guess we are going to talk to you for a bit. So then, could you tell me more about the lifestyle of the people in this place? No? Is that, like, too much to ask for? Alright, if you insist. Anyway, bye now. Alright, so we are essentially headed back to Toad and the Fawn in... oh yeah, Toad and the Fawn. Crosswick. Right. On a horse. Find Crosswick again. I'm glad that the name of this piece is pretty tame. Anyway. A young lad hands you a letter and scurries off. Again, huh? So the plot thickens. Inventory. Quest giver. Letter from the quest giver, and this is from the letter from the replace. The Order of Arkay, Illicent Hills, initiates strange blood. Bedorian Asham has failed to meet with the man whom she was to report his findings in the Shrine of Demax. We must assume the worst. You are hereby ordered to either find Bedorian Asham himself or his body in the Shrine of Demax and report back to me. All other assignments and investigations take lower priority. I was honestly hoping to not receive that letter. But let's see. Yeah, ultimately we apparently do now have to head into the dungeon nonetheless. I mean, it's sort of sad because... Wait. Oh, sorry. That's the mouse and the barbarian. So, which one? Toad and the Fawn, right? I think it's that one? That one? Yeah, so, it's sort of sad because even the last time I had to just dungeon crawl. Like, crawl through the dungeon. No other option apart from that. Are you the one that I want to talk to? yeah, replace. Yep, you are. By the dragon, strange bird. It was dreadful. The tavern keep found Crystaria Girton in one of the rooms, her body defiled in the most horrifying way. A grim parody of the old, the Order of Arkay mortuary rites. It was Rhetorian Wickfield, no doubt. This relic was found in Crystaria Girton's chest cavity. See if Barbona Yomton in Greenham Manor recognizes it. Right then. So, we should have got the relic now. Let us try solving this quest that way. The how do you shove a holy tome in somebody's chest? How do you stab someone with it? Holy hell, that guy's a brute. So, I'll try to... Yeah, Queen of Mana. So I'll So this is a dungeon. This is the place that we need to go. I'll try to essentially complete the quest this way, but if I cannot complete it this way, then we'll head to the dungeon that was mentioned to us earlier. Yeah, I'll try to head to the dungeon that was mentioned to us earlier if I cannot complete the quest this way. I think this was the home. Yep. In here, if I recall correctly. Holy tome! Damn the dragon! That's poor Redderin Wickfield's property. By the wolf, I knew he was unstable, but I never thought he'd really do it. Death be damned, poor Crystaria Girton. If I had helped her, she'd still be alive today. This won't make up for what I've done by failing to act, but you know what to do with this letter. May RK forgive me. Okay, right. The letter from the prophet. Excuse me there. Barbona Yomton, my love. First, forgive the silence of your love. It was not another attack of brain fever. For some months now, I've been in spiritual turmoil, unfit for any company, even for the comfort of your dulcet fellowship. My days of pain are over, but for this, I can never see you again. My life has a higher purpose than the fulfillment of a ridiculous love affair now. No longer can I suffer the evil of the Order of Arkay. The evil they did to me, and the evil they are doing to all of Tamriel. The days the prophet Maruk spoke of are on us again. I must rally the people by any and all lies, innuendo, bigotry, and threats to rise against the spiritual tyranny of the Order of Arkay. Marouk, that name sounds familiar. Forgive me, my former love, and if you can forget me, and if you can, forget me. And if you can do neither, do not see me. If you do, I will slay you and stick candles in your eyes and twine your organs with beads for the greater glory of the gods of the universe. Fill the young lady in green. Torment me no longer, Rodorian Wickfield. He has been quite unkind to you, hasn't he? Thank you for this, by the way.
Bye.
Alright, let's try heading back to Illicent Hills now and turning it in. If it doesn't work, we'll have to go dungeon crawling. I like this questline, it's like sort of an investigative mystery, not exactly the standard. Go inside the dungeon and fetch me that. Even though it has the potential of turning into that anyway. It snows! Okay, so we should be heading... northwest. Let us see if we can complete this quest like this, otherwise we'll just have to enter the dungeon. That's all we can do. And it's gonna be another dungeon crawl. The last time that I did this quest, it was a long dungeon crawl. I mean, that was partly my fault because I only found the objective right near the entrance, a part which I had, you know, hadn't checked until later. But the point still stands that it might be like a very long dungeon crawl. Might also be a short one, you never know. One of the issues with this game, I already recognize this temple, it's on the map. Yeah. The issue with Daggerfall Unity is the fact that you cannot exactly... Where is... Ah. Well done, Initiate. I tremble to think what Rodorian Wickfield might have done to a temple had he spread his profane word. Arkay bless you and keep you, goodly brethren. Here, a small token of the esteem of your brethren. A sapphire. Thank you. Thank you for that. So, fuck the priest, I guess. that is essentially what this all boils down to. Fuck the priest. Let's save it again. And let us talk to him. Get quest, yes. Initiate, the Order of Arkay needs you for a dangerous mission to retrieve one of the lost talismans of Arkay. You will have to defy the power of Jibodur, its creator, who then betrayed the temple and sank into evil. He is now a lich and still guards the talisman. Are you willing? Okay. I admire your courage, but tremble to think about the danger you are about to face. Jibodur guards his talisman of Arkay in ruins of Masterheart Manor. Remember, there is no need to slay the lich, just retrieve the talisman and return it to the Order of Arkay here. If we have no word from you in 18 days, we will chant the song of the departed for you. Yikes. Arkay's blessings upon you, strange bird. I doubt I'm ready to face a lich, but let's see. So, ruins of Masterheart Manor. Yeah. Let's go. It's dusk right now. It looks so pretty. It looks so pretty. Master and Secunda, look at that. Holy hell, this looks so pretty. So gorgeous. Anyhow. Actually, grab mode. Right. Now I wonder whether... Oh, okay. Dungeon save. Holy hell. Okay, I've got an elven broadsword right here at least. I'll let those guys fight amongst each other before I go ahead and do that. And the skelly one, of course he did, because why would he not? Pretty Warm welcome for beginning, I suppose. Let's rest here. I hope nobody walks in on me doing this. Right, save one. Right, we're back. And since there were enemies on this side, maybe we'll go ahead and check out the same side first. And we'll leave the other side for later. Gold pieces and leather cuirass and leather boots. I'm glad to see though that I'm now able to handle skeletons without many issues. And that's a bad deal. The positive of all of this is the fact that I will be able to essentially level up with this little quest. Hi there. This guy's dead. Okay, Aquas form. Pretty sure there should be nothing here, but you never know. Aquas form. The old anxious music. There's a chair there. A slaughter fish. Nothing here. So liches won't be underwater that much. I can, yeah, let's just avoid that thing. And nothing here from the looks of it. Oh, wait, there's another tool here. Where does this go? A lot more drugs. Drugs, or I don't know how you pronounce that. Okay. So liches can easily see through my disguise. I see a skelly there. Let me just deal with this one. Right. And then let us go and save you. Save too. Right. The bleed is one of minor skills, being the reason why I opted to choose it. I see a human enemy there. But first, let me go and loot whatever this is. And now, this is gonna burn you for a bit. Oh, that was powerful. Very powerful. Iron claymore, helm. Nothing else of interest here. Now, there are two parts here. Whoa, that is really zoomed in. But let's drop bead there, we'll explode later. I hope that I do not have to come face to face with the lich. I'm carrying a dagger because that is one of my minor skills. The use of the dagger, I mean. And I'm trying to use it as much as possible so that I can take care of that little weakness of mine as well. Let's save again. Save 3. I should really not be overwriting the same save slot multiple times. I see a human enemy there. Dagger. Actually, yes, let us go ahead and use this. You thought there was some there, did you? Dragon scales, aloe. Anything else? No. Cast invisibility. And yeah. You can't even hear me walking about, can you? Actually, poison dart, damage health, damage fatigue, chumama, continuous damage health. Right, so I guess we should be casting this more than the poison dart spell. I did want to cast haste. Right, leech vitals. I have the spell, interesting. What is this person again? A nightblade. Save was a spell made. I do not have enough spell points. We can cast haste later. Hi. I'm playing like an assassin right now. Mummy wrappings. Steel boots. Pretty sure that these mummy wrappings are pretty putrid and won't be any good to us as they are right now. So I can hear stuff, but how did I didn't do that. Can't cast haste yet, but I can probably save over the same slot. Alright then, there was another part that had left exposed right here. Yeah. So I'll just keep that there and we go onwards. Ah, blind as a bat, huh? Come on, get out of the way. Don't make me kill you. So how much is my speed right now? Just 76? Okay, not too shabby, I suppose. Like, how much does it hasten me, though? Is what I want to know. Fortify attribute. Okay. Okay, 11 to 18. Makes sense. Makes sense. Which way are we headed now? Let's go upstairs. We'll check out this side later. We're just going where the road takes us. Oh, shit. Holy shit. Oh, hell no. Wait, am I paralyzed? Wait. Heal wounds? Yes. I would like to cast that again, but am I paralyzed? It would seem to be the case, yes. And the spell points for that. Holy sh fuck. Right then, I'll save my stats. And we're gonna save in the emergency slot right here because the lich is probably right next door. Yeah, and we're just gonna drop this bead right here. this guy's gonna be around the corner. Oh, thanks for the blast of energy there, but yeah, I'll just go ahead and cast free action on myself. Finally. I killed a lich. Amazing. I killed a lich. I can't believe it. Without losing any health at that. Oh, so I guess I'm just literally absorbing all the damage that a spell does. That's why spells don't affect me at all. Interesting. Anyhow, I'll go ahead and save on this slot then. What's even more amazing is the fact that the skeleton did not give cheese, but what's bad is the fact that this guy did not have what we were looking for. This is short shirt, secure walls, a history of locksmithing. It'll probably boost my locksmith skill up. But this guy did not have what we were looking for, did he? We essentially need to retrieve the relic. So with the biggest threat of this dungeon out of the way, I suppose the rest of the way might just be pretty easy. But who knows. Oh, there it is, the relic. Yeah, right there. Hi. Oh, wait. The talisman. This is surely the Order of Arkay's long-lost talisman. I recall not having casted a recall anchor there. I recall not having done that. So, with that in mind, let us head back the only way we know how and make a break for it. That way? Yeah. Glad to see that this is finally peeling off. Right, we hit the street and under the water again. The first chance that we get, Aqueous Form. Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Aqueous Form. Yeah, right here. I like the fact that all my spells are so cheap. For a second there I thought that was a fly view, but it actually was not. Come on, you can go down. Thank you. Here we go. Finally coming back upstairs. I hear more skeletons, but I do not want to have to do anything with them, so yeah. Actually, I did not mean to do that, but since we are here, we might as well just remove these to the wagon. They will surely sell for some amount of money. Short shoot? Sure, why not? I guess. Doesn't... Oh, of course. Has to be in my inventory. Sapphire and everything else. Alright. So, apparently we could have just avoided the lich and just, you know, address the talisman itself, but I wasn't particularly aware that that was a possibility, especially considering the fact that where's Mercer and Sekunda though? I was thinking that the talisman might just be on the lich, but that was not the case, which they pretty much did imply at the in the briefing, but I guess I was not paying attention. Let us try teleporting though. Nah, did I? I don't think I did. Yeah, I must set an anchor. Right. Alright. I suppose we headed back to the Listen Hilton. That was a short and sweet little dungeon tour. We got lucky, essentially. You have ascended to level 5, and from here on out, we can essentially complete mainline quests. I mean, there's no such hard and fast rule, per se. You can begin doing that from level 3 onwards. Just that I wanted to get to level 5 before I started addressing any of those quests. And here we are. You've ascended to level 5. Everything you do is just a bit easier, more instinctive, more satisfying. It is as though you had suddenly developed keen senses and instincts. A red-faced courier startles you with a cry of letter for strange blood. Hey, that must be you. Here, take this. Gotta go. Other deliveries to be made. Huh. Interesting. So, before we get to that, we'll just go ahead and what do you want to spend 4 points on, though? Willpower, definitely. And what else? What else? What else? Intelligence, maybe? Or agility? Endurance. Let's go with endurance. Right. 111 health. And what's the progress to the next level though? Yeah, level 5. 0% progress to the next level, I love it. yeah, right. The letter that we just received. I wonder what that is. Red-faced man. Castle Sentinel. Okay, maybe it's Prince, what's his name, calling us. Strange, but yeah, Prince Lotum. Greetings and salutations. I hope your trip was uneventful. They say that you're keenly interested in the haunting of Daggerfall. My father and King Lysandus were somewhat close. Should you come visit me, I might be able to shed some light upon recent events involving Lysandus. Prince Lotum, Castle Sentinel. Yeah, unfortunately, we'll not be addressing that letter, because I do not intend to help them at all, like Sentinel, for this playthrough. I've got nothing against those people, it's just that I want to keep, with the fact that there's only so much you can do in Daggerfall, and the fact that I'm going to be replaying it as a mage, like I'm replaying it as a mage, I already played it as a warrior, and I'm going to be replaying it again as a thief. I want to keep even the main quest compartmentalized, so yeah, I'm gonna be, apart from all the main quests that are absolutely necessary, which the central quests are not, by the way. You can actually gain the location of both the dungeons, the main quest dungeons that you need to gain the locations for from the Mage's Guild itself, and that is pretty much what I'm aiming to do here. So typically Sentinel is important, the Sentinel quests, because they give you the location of the other mainline quests, dungeons essentially of the mainline quests. But yeah, what? You not only retrieve the sacred talisman but also kill the evil Jubuder? You are truly one of Arkay's favored ones. You will surely rise far in our order. How about we start now? Yeah? Seems like a good idea to me. Praise to great Arkay, I had not allowed myself to hope that you would actually succeed. Arkay's favor will surely shine upon you for this deed. As a small token of the temple's gratitude, please accept this enchanted scarab. I'm guessing that was like a second scarab. Of course, I need to get it identified. Why wouldn't I? Oh my god. Can I like equip this somehow? Apparently not. These are only to be kept in my inventory for whatever reason. So yeah, that should get us to where we can get promoted. Let's see. Alright then. I'm healed. Of course, that means I got a promotion. The Order of Arkay, in recognition of your tireless efforts to bring harmony and order to Illicent Hills and all of the Illiac Bay, hereby officially recognizes you as an acolyte of the Order. An acolyte. If I may, congratulations, acolyte Strangeblood. Thank you very much, it has been an honor. Now then, I see you've casted the spell of invisibility on yourself then. Anyhow, so that's pretty much what we wanted to do with this. Like, we achieved pretty much both of the things that we wanted to do with this playthrough. But what? Yeah, it doesn't really give me anything, does it? Daedra summoning. We can, like, buy potions from him. What potions do you have? Cure disease? Yeah, let us go ahead and take that. Purification? Sure. A resist poison? Sure. Fire, heal true, chameleon form, not really, slow falling, water breathing, cure poison, sure. We'll buy all those. What? Excuse me? What? Okay. Cure disease, that's like 300 gold. Okay, purification is probably what pushed it over the edge there. Yeah. 932. And it was like two potions of purification at that, so I suppose it makes sense. In a way. So yeah, the main reason that... I can't do any of that yet. Are you like a trainer of sorts? I suppose not. You're pretty much useless. Training, right. Could you train me in... Restoration magic. For a session in restoration, it will cost you 1077 gold. Still interested, acolyte? Sure. You and the trainer practice for 3 hours. The trainer tells you to reflect on what you've learned and see if you can put it to good use. Right then. And there's nothing else here. Except for this woman that is facing out. So yeah. The entire reason that Sentinel is... Let me save first. So yeah, the entire reason that Sentinel is important to the main quest is that it gives you the dungeon locations of two of the main quest dungeons that are of quite a significant importance. Now, the alternative means for you to get those quest locations is to actually go to the region that the dungeon is located in, join a faction there, and complete their quests. Or if you have already joined a faction like the Fighter's Guild or the Mage's Guild, like me, if you want to know the location of that place in Minavia, what I'm doing is I'm going to Minivia and I'm just picking up random quests from the Mage's Guild. And I mean, it is of course RNG based, but if you have been doing that from the very starting of the game, the chances are high that you'll discover the location of the place that you need to find organically. They'll eventually end up sending you to that location. Otherwise, you can just go and save scum and you'll find the location of that place nonetheless. I wish I could peer inside of buildings from the outside. Yeah, but that would require them to load up a lot of tiny little elements into the memory, wouldn't it? Anyhow, so yeah, that's like one of the more important dungeons that's of greater significance later on in the game. For the dungeon that comes of significance sooner, Prince Lodron's quest, the quest that he's summoning us for, that same quest will essentially... give us the location of yet another dungeon, in which, you know, one of the people that were close to him reside. And that person in turn will also have like a bunch of quests for us, mainline quests, all important quests, by the way. So yeah, Sentinel is only important to figure out the location of the dungeons. Now, that dungeon is on the Isle of Balfiera. It's basically right here, in this isle right here. And if you want to know the quest of that dungeon, know the location of the dungeon, it's called the Dedenne Tower. You can even see it marked on the map right here. So yeah, if you want to know the quest of that, the location of this dungeon, you can either complete Lodron's quest, or you can complete like random faction quests in the Isle of Balfiera itself. Alternatively, if you have the CompUSA USA patch installed, which like the USB version of Daggerfall has by default, you can essentially just travel to any Mage's Guild and wait for them to give you a quest wherein you have to go find a mage and essentially slay them. They will not be planning an uprising like the previous one that I had completed for them. It's not like a revolt or an uprising sort of plot, it's just a mage that has strayed from the ways of the Mage's Guild and has, you know, it's more or less disgracing them. Not even disgracing them, it's just existence is antithetical to their ideology. So that's why they send you to kill him, but if you do not kill him, the follow-up quest that it generates will actually lead you to Dedenne Tower. And yeah, that's practically another way to figure out how to get to Dedenne Tower without actually completing any of the central quests. So yeah, that. So with that being said, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around until the end. Especially even when I'm trying to explain all the little intricacies of how this all works. So yeah, the next time we come back, we will most likely be talking to... we'll either complete like a bunch of quests for the Mage's Guild, or we will talk to Lysandus. That's one of the maids in the kitchen of Daggerfall. So yeah, next stop is most likely going to be either Minivia, the Mage's Guild in Minivia, or Castle Daggerfall. And yeah, until then, see you later. Take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings. Enjoy the sight of the setting sun.